Conor McGregor. All right, here we go. Round one, Tony Ferguson versus Conor McGregor. Hard to know what Tony's going to do early, late in the fight. Your thoughts on what's
happening? Oh!
Well, the right hand has been there at times, not that time. Oh, is that a big knee to the body? We'll see if he can follow up.
He loaded up there on that high kick. Those are big strikes.
Now goes in and secures the takedown. Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions. And oh, now trying to isolate an arm, DC.
He needs to move his hips back to cover. He cannot allow him on that angle. He's a tech arm bar now.
Nicely done. All right, so he postures up here and now figures to rain down some ground strikes.
Yeah, the ground and pound will be a plenty from this position.
Man, this is some serious ground and pound here, DC. He's not just staying busy for the sake of staying busy. These strikes are doing damage.
Oh, yeah, no pity pass to this guy. This guy's trying to land, and he's trying to land effective strikes. Big punch lands over the top. How's he going to follow this one up? Look at the force behind that leg kick. Oh, nice.
So just over 20 total strikes have now landed for El Kukui, Tony Ferguson. That's a hell of a kick right there. He told us Thursday that he was going to be kick-heavy tonight, and that is certainly a step in the right direction.
Quick entry here. Nice single-leg entry. Rotates the head outside to a high crotch.
Oh!
Deep, flips him over the top. What a huge takedown.
I mean, do I survive that, or did
no,
I read my
John,
last right?
Absolutely not. You don't survive that. It's over. It's over, John.
All right, full guard now, DC.
The fighter on top needs to be trying to gain posture to throw ground and pound and then move to the next position. But if you're on the bottom, you've got to build a shield. Try to push your opponent off to try to get
Ferguson's
back to
Ferguson's going for the leg. Might be a submission opportunity here. Oh, he postured up there, and he's out. Nice hammer fist. His opponent squirming like a fish out of water now. The ground and pound is on point. This could very well be the beginning of the end.
This could be the beginning of the end. We've seen some really good ground and pound fighters. This young man is as good as any we've ever seen. Can't take many of those. Better check.
The horn sounds for the end of round one. All right, let's take a look back at some of the replays from that last one.
Unbelievable to see these high-level competitors get in each other's face, tuck their chin, bite down on the mouth guard, and just let it all hang out over the course of 5 minutes.
Take a seat. Deep breath. Breathe. Take a drink. All right, here we go. Listen, you're doing absolutely awesome. I want you to...
All right, second round now. Tony Ferguson.
Ready?
Against that man, you might recognize him. He is Conor McGregor.
Oh, he got everything behind that kick.
Knee lands there.
That knee hurt him.
Oh!
Nice leg kick.
Oh, nice strike landed there by Ferguson. Continues to mix it up, going to the head, mixing in some body shots. Oh, massive knee up top. Quick entry.
Great single entry. Rotates the high crotch. Taking for a ride. Oh, takes it for a ride. What a fantastic takedown. And now he has a headlock trying to pin his opponent's back down flat onto the mat. Look from the transition to an arm triangle to try to chase the finish. Watch triangle. Watch triangle.
under 3 minutes now remain in round two. All right, well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you got to be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent. All right, side control now. Outstanding ground and pound here. Somewhat of a lost art in MMA, at least in terms of making sure that every strike counts. Not an issue for him.
He's making every single one of them count. He is not pity-patting. He's not touching. Every punch that lands, he wants you to feel it.
Beautiful movement, hip work on the ground here, just outstanding with the transitions.
He is not staying in one place on the ground. That's very important.
All right, north-south position here. We'll see if the crowd can be mature about this, DC. Oh, really nice work to keep busy off of his back as he lands some more offense here for Bob. Oh, wow, that happened quickly as the fighter reverses position there on the ground.
Unbelievable position change. Wow, what a transition.
Both fighters back to their feet now. So 55 total strikes have now landed for Tony Ferguson. And landing with 56% accuracy, pretty good, against Conor McGregor. So a much different approach for him here in this second round. He was a little bit tentative in round one, a little bit of a feeling out process. Now he has clearly found his rhythm, found strike lands there, and somehow his opponent's chin held up.
His opponent's chin held up, but you do not want to be on the receiving end of those types of strikes.
Switching stances here. Lionel's quick entry to get
Man,
him on a
that
single.
Was a great single. Oh, takes him for a ride. Slams him on his back. What a takedown.
How's that feel to be a man into that? So the crowd voicing its appreciation after that round. We had a knockdown courtesy of a punch midway through. DC, here's your highlight.
It was straight. He threw him in combination and landed that big punch that really did hurt his opponent. Lesser men would have been done. He's got a tough guy in front of him. He will have to go back to this again. He will have to get back to this action if he wants to get the desired finish.
You ready?
Here we go, third round of this championship fight. Well, most fighters can't keep up this type of aggression and pace, but you don't have to worry about this guy. He hasn't really showed any signs of slowing down tonight. El Kukui gets caught with that punch. Combination lands for him. It was hard to see a miss in that sequence. He's put it all together.
I mean, everything is just flowing. It's like in a zone. It's like the basketball hoop becomes quite.
Could be out of here soon, DC.
He's almost done. I mean, when you get hit with a shot like that, you don't know whether run, hide, grab, or wrestle. He's confused. He's as confused as he was on his first test in elementary school.
76 total strikes have now landed for Conor. Landing with 70% accuracy tonight against Tony Ferguson. I love watching this guy move on the ground.
You gotta watch him attack his submissions. He throws the legs up to try to get a triangle choke here. Watch triangle. There he is. He's moving to the finisher position. Now watch him.
Oh, man, that was slick.
Well, he's in a compromising spot here, DC. You got to figure out a way to get back to your feet. A lot of top pressure being applied here. Oh, McGregor's lower jaw does not look good. I don't think it's broken, but starting to show some obvious signs of slump. All right, side control now. We'll see if he can advance position. Lands the ground and pound strike.
He's putting him in exactly the position he needs to be in right now.
Do you believe it? Oh, and there comes the stoppage.
Unbelievable. What a fight.
Yeah, that right there is a high-level knockout, ladies and gentlemen. Crowd absolutely loving it. Just a perfect shot to end the fight. Landed flush. I'm not even sure his opponent saw it coming. So a huge, huge win for that young fighter here tonight. Inside the octagon once again, here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Bergliotta has called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 56 seconds of the third round, declaring the winner by knockout, and still the undisputed UFC lightweight champion of the world, Tony
So there he is, the still UFC lightweight champion of the world. A lot of steam here during fight week that maybe there were a few things that could plague him tonight. Looked as good as ever for my money.
He looked as good as he's ever looked inside the octagon. He's so good at everything, every single skill that you need to become champ. He has mastered, and he showed it in this fight.